Actress Anne Hathaway showed what it means to have solidarity with workers when she decided to basically walk out of a photo shoot, a Vanity Fair photo shoot to be exact, after hearing that Condé Nast Union was staging a 24-hour walkout. Now, nearly 400 union members who work at Condé Nast are currently holding a 24-hour work stoppage to basically protest the layoffs and negotiation practices they claim are unlawful. So just to give you an idea, Condé Nast is not like struggling financially. They can't claim that that's the reason for the layoffs. In November, CEO Roger Lynch announced that expected revenue was up for a third straight year, but that the company needed to lay off 5% of their workers, roughly 300 people, including 94 employees in the union. Now, the company also announced last week that its music outlet Pitchfork is being folded into GQ, resulting in several layoffs. And the union is arguing that management has violated labor laws by reducing its proposed severance offer for laid off employees. But there's more. Other alleged workplace violations. For instance, 94 union members is almost 20% of our union. The company is legally obligated to bargain over these layoffs, but they allege that that bargain didn't happen. And so they warned last week that they were planning to stage a walkout, 24-hour walkout, writing on X that nearly 400 of us have pledged to stop work when our bargaining committee calls for a 24-hour walkout. A retweet to tell Condé Nast you stand with workers, stop breaking the law, stop union busting, and stop the layoffs. And guess what? They did follow through on what they threatened to do. The day after the Academy Award nominations were announced, normally a very busy time for Condé Nast writers, employees at Vanity Fair, Vogue, GQ, Allure, Glamour, and other Condé Nast publications walked out to hold a rally in front of the company's offices in New York. And then Anne Hathaway got involved. So apparently Hathaway was completely unaware of the work stoppage when she arrived at the New York City photo shoot. She was still in hair and makeup when her team was notified by a staffer from SAG-AFTRA to advise Hathaway to support the work stoppage. The source said they hadn't even started taking photos yet. Once Anne was made aware of what was going on, she got up from hair and makeup and left. And so Hathaway standing with the Condé Nast workers is particularly fitting when you consider some of the movies that she has starred in, especially The Devil Wears Prada, one of my favorite movies. It's one of those movies that I watch at least once a year because it's always enjoyable. And in that film, she plays the role of an intern at Vogue, and she has this incredibly cruel boss. It's a fictional magazine, right, called Runway, but it's based off of Vogue. Meryl Streep's character was based on Anna Wintour, who's a longtime editor-in-chief of Vogue. And it was reported this week that Wintour kept her sunglasses on while laying off Condé Nast employees, which is like so gross. But anyway, before I get to more details of this story, I'm curious what you think so far, John.
Well, I'm very glad that not too many weeks ago, I for the first time ever saw most of that movie. So I feel prepared to talk about this. And it was not bad. Bearing in mind that, no, it's a fine movie. I was more invested in it than I thought it would be. But anyway, bearing in mind that Anne Hathaway is an incredibly wealthy person who's gonna be perfectly fine no matter what happens. I like this. I think especially when you dive into like sort of the timeline of when she and her team found out about this, you know, it might seem like, well, the obvious thing is that you walk out, but in the moment she hears that there's gonna be the stoppage. Does she have the time or the ability to do research into what negotiations have happened or not? You know, she doesn't necessarily have the ability to really know a lot about what's going on. And so you feel the pressure to act without a lot of information and potentially with consequences if you are perceived to have gotten it wrong. Her walking out could have consequences to people who are, you know, like struggling to survive. They don't seem like significant consequences, her not maybe getting more covers or something, but that is her life and she is willing to risk that to send a message. And so I do admire that. It reminds me of You know, there were the actors who, like when the SAG-AFTRA strike was announced, they were like right about to do events for, I think it was for Oppenheimer and for Barbie, and they immediately stopped right then. I love when people use their platform like that, particularly when they're risking, you know, damage to their career.
I totally agree. And, you know, her instinct was, I need to support the workers, even if she didn't have all the details behind the 24-hour work stoppage. And that is a good instinct to have, especially as someone who's an actress. And remember, very recently, there was a strike for actors and actresses. And I'm sure they enjoyed the solidarity. So to return that for the Condé Nast unionized workers, I think makes a lot of sense. And I'm happy to see that she did that. So just a lot of credit to Anne Hathaway.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member. And members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence. And that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.